Hey, this is Havikster from SNKCapcom.com, and I am here with none other than the hardest working man in our scene, Mr. Spooky from Team Spooky. Spooky, thank you so much for joining us.
Sure. What's good?
Now, got a couple of questions for you, similar to what we did back in Canada Cup. I know you were planning to going to T11, but weren't able to get the passport on time. Now you're finally able to make it to T12. Is it everything you thought that it was going to be?
Yeah, but I mean, I was already familiar with the T series, and I knew, you know, pretty much what Toronto's been doing for a while. So, you know, this is close to what I expected. I'm glad that more people showed up than they were expecting originally. Originally, I think they thought they were going to get around 120 to 150. They've got to have double that.
Easily 300. Yeah. What Russell was telling me yesterday is phenomenal. You're finding the venue okay?
The venue's good. The hotel's all right, you know what I mean? The main thing is that the organizers, between Russell, RXS, and the whole rest of the crew, you know, have handled it really well, despite the fact that, you know, pretty much they got double what they could have possibly expected.
Right. That room was pretty crammed yesterday, but people were still enjoying themselves and having a great time.
Great.
So how's the streaming been treating you since last time we spoke in November?
It's been going well. Evolution was a big success for us. 2 million views, 85,000 I think was the peak.
Wow.
For people watching. So and since then, you know, we've still been planning out. Pretty much at this point, what we're doing is we're upgrading our technology. So we moved from 30 FPS to 60 FPS, which looks
beautiful.
Real nice. It's super smooth. It looks great.
Oh yeah.
And we're working on that, you know, minor upgrades to the technology, because basically what we want to do now is now that we've kind of been established and we've done this, you know, as far as majors for a year or so.
Right.
We want to, you know, on the run back, we want to, you know, make them more real nice. So since Beans is coming up, that should be super godlike. NEC, find around for next year in March should be great, that sort of thing.
Wow.
So that's the main thing, is focusing on what we already have, but making them bigger.
You got your work cut out for you, man. So any new ambitions in the horizon? I mean, you're doing these different streams. Do you have any like major sort of like big projects that's long-term?
The long-term project has less to do with me and more to do with the companies themselves. But the long-term project right now is getting more companies like Capcom and Namco involved, but not just in an advertising sort of capacity where you just come by and say, oh, hey, you know, this is an official Capcom sponsored event. You know, I want to see them put in more pop bonuses or more actual prizes.
Right.
Or, you know, or help fund the tournaments. There are tournaments that are established and they're growing bigger, and, you know, they need equipment, whether they need 360s or PS3s or whatever else. I like to see some other companies step in now and start to help the community tournaments more.
Excellent. And now, in your opinion, since you have such a broad perspective, probably more than any, you know, player in the scene, because you've pretty much been to everything, how do you feel about the way the fighting game community is evolving?
I think it's excellent, especially right now. It's showing itself as most powerful, and when I say that, I mean because Super, especially Arcade Edition, and Marvel 3 are both considered games that are pretty unbalanced. And we've gone through this before in 2006 or 2007, where you know, there were a lot of games that were out, but there were really no new games coming, and you know, there weren't really a lot of newcomers to the scene because, you know, the games that were out there, either, you know, you had to have been playing a long time to be really solid at them, or you didn't like them. If you didn't like Third Strike or CBS2 or Marvel, then you're screwed, that's it. And you know, it's kind of a similar situation now. We have two games that aren't really that good, but the scene is holding it together regardless. They're still coming out and playing. Even JS Master, man, he used to be an amazing boxer player from up here, and now,
yeah,
you know,
now
boxer is kind of lit up in Arcade Edition, so you know, he's a little on the emo side. But you know, regardless, you know, people are keeping it together, which I think is good, because when we do come into the new patches, Ultimate Marvel and A2012, I'm hoping that you know, we'll be able to flourish.
Right. Now, on the topic of games, there are so many games coming up in the horizon right now. You know, you got the Street Fighter Cross Tekken, you got the Ultimate Marvel 3, you got the Skullgirls, you got King of Fighters 13, you got all these other games. Do you feel there are too many games coming out, much like the whole fighting game craze back when Street Fighter 2 came out? Do you think it'll dwindle down anytime soon?
I don't think it'll dwindle down, because I feel that for the games that are coming, there are some that are being designed to be competitive. Like, I think Street Fighter Cross Tekken, they're probably designing that to be a competitive game. Versus, you know, and Skullgirls also, you know, Mike Z, the way he works at it, is designed to be competitive. Versus some of the other games like Aquapaza and there's another one that I can't think of that I know is coming out soon. I think are more kind of fanboy games. They're just developed to kind of just establish a fan base, get some good guys to buy it, and they're not really meant to be competitive. So I think that's okay. It's good to have like that fair share. You know what I mean? So I think even though there are like a lot of games coming out, I think there's enough room for everything right now.
Good. That's how I'm feeling too. And I don't think the scene's ever been like this, considering the number of games. People are being more receptive to these games and whatnot. It's definitely a good time to be in the fighting game community. Any final thoughts, shout-outs?
No, not really. Well, shout-out to Toronto Top Tiers for putting this together, and shout-out to all the sponsors for the event. Galaxy, ANC, and I know there's two more, but, you know, it's first thing in the water.
Hey, it's all good, man.
Shout-out to those guys for putting the event together. That's the main thing. But as far as final thoughts, man, I just hope that you guys keep doing what you're doing up here because, like I said, you know, T-Series, this is the 12th year running now, and it's definitely showing itself as established and successful. So I hope that, you know, that you guys bring it back next year and that
perfect.
It comes out good.
Again, thank you very much, Spooky, for doing this with me. It's always a pleasure having you up here in Canada. We would love to have you for more events.
Cool, thank you.
And I'm looking forward to seeing more of your work, more of your ambitions. This is Hibixter from SNK Capcom signing off.